Definition of monitoring. Monitoring employee performance is structured, planned, and actively where both you and your employees collect examples and samples of their actual performance for comparison against the performance objectives we have agreed. So in simple terms, the objectives and the performance measure which is set by your organization and your team head, and based on that we can collect the information from your employees about their performance, and we have to compare their actual performance with the standard given by the organization. So what are the main objectives of monitoring the performance? The first one is the process of promoting a climate of continuous learning and development. So we know very well, every organization, they tend to get a good development of their employees and their contribution towards the organization. Such development is only with promoting a good climate, which changes the mindset of your employees, and then you align your employees with the organizational objective. That is only possible with promoting a climate of about learning, and this learning is a continuous process in an organization, because due to technology, due to globalization, due to getting the competitive advantage, and due to getting good performance from your employees, everybody has to promote a learning climate. Such organizations are called learning organizations. For example, you can take TCS, or you can take Infosys, and recently the Google has initiated the new learning platforms for their existing employees as well as unemployed youth. So why they create such kind of platform is for promoting a climate that allows the employees to learn and development themselves. It is not a simple task. It involves so many aspects, such as the training and development activities by the organization, the industrial development, career planning. So this type of development process, which are very crucial for employees' development. For monitoring your employees, you need to create such kind of climate, and you can easily assess and monitor. The second objective is helping to sustain employee performance at a planned level. At a planned level, how can we help? It is only possible with the employee sustainability. It is not a simple thing, because if you want to manage your employees with a compensation package, or else existing salary, or else the betterments given by the organization, which not only develop the performance of your employee, even if you monitor themselves with very closely, and if you planned the monitoring process, and you clearly mention those monitoring aspects and controlling aspects to your employees, so that they can be very happy and they can take care of themselves also. So you have to create the performance at a planned level. The third objective is to enhance the individual competencies. How can we enhance the individual competencies? It is only possible with encouraging your employees and their performance, by giving rewards, by giving appraisal, whatever we discussed earlier classes. So that is only the thing that enhances the competencies and that make the employees more competitive within the organization. So what exactly we get through these competencies and employee competitive nature, for we get the productive contributions. Every organization, every manager, every team leader, they are expecting the contributions from their employees and the team members. So how can they contribute and how can they improve their contribution towards the organization? It is only possible with developing the competencies among the employees. For such kind of competencies development, the organization has to give the rewards. Sometimes they go for the competition about new policy making, new development career opportunities, conduct quiz. For example, if you take the Tata Group, they are welcoming and encouraging intrapreneurs, right? So whenever they encourage the intrapreneurs, the employees should work more. They can give the more contribution to organization as well as they develop their competency levels. So in such manner, the Tata Group has encouraged the intrapreneurs. Such activity really helped the new startups and especially those they are belong to Tata Group. They are the employees of the Tata Group. They invested. And they also initiated one more thing for encouraging the entrepreneurs, and they will give some competencies and they conduct some competitions about a great business plan or a good business plan. And they wish to invest or else they will provide a financial assistance. In that manner, they encourage the people's competency, not only their employees, they develop the social competencies also. That is one of the matter today, that how you connected with your company and society. Because if you want to monitor an employee, you have to take 360 degree appraisal today. You don't think that how the employee has core competencies. Apart from the core competencies, they're required to get the more. That is today, most happening issue, right? The objectives of monitoring. First, to provide learning, training and development opportunities to employees. To improve individual job performance, as well as the methods and techniques of measuring performance. Third one is to review the ways of defining and agreeing of performance criteria of teams and individual employees at the performance planning level. So we have already covered what is performance planning and what is performance planning process. In that performance process level, we have to know and define what is performance criteria. For individuals, what is the criteria, and a team, what is the criteria? So based on that, we can assess the performance of employee as well as we can easily monitor your employees. The fourth one is to assess commitment and motivational level. So commitment is one of the factor which shows job satisfaction of an employee. Because if an employee is committed towards the work, or finishing a work or a task within a period of time, it speaks their commitment towards the job. However, the motivational level to accept and realize the performance and feedback is given, it is a positive perspective about an employee. To incorporate change necessitated by external environment and it really affect overall performance improvement of the organization. These are very crucial aspects. Now, what are the principles of monitoring and evaluation? So first one is improve the quality of policy and decision making. So every organization, they have a policy And the policy should have a quality control policy, or else the quality of work life, especially in performance management, it speaks about the performance quality. The policy which relates to improve the performance level by the factors which influencing the employee satisfaction, and it is easy to monitor by the managers and top level managers, especially in promotion criteria, because taking a decision towards an organization or else a functional body in the organization or promoting or demoting an employee in an organization, it is not a simple task. So that is the reason you should have a principle that really attracts and followed by all the people in your organization. It don't have any deviance, or whatever the decision you take, you should, or it lies with the quality of policy. So these are all very important principles in monitoring and evaluation. The second one is learn and improve performance. So the performance improvement is only possible with learning. It is one of the major objective of the performance. That is the reason today, the most of the companies, they are trained their employees, especially the IT companies, they used to give training and development programs to their employees for every quarter. The reason is that if they learn, definitely they will improve the performance level. Because here, they simply hit and run, hit and run, hit and run, hit and run. That's the reason they can produce the more productivity. The third principle is plans and targets should promote outcomes. Plans and targets should promote outcomes. So whatever the plans you have and the whatever the targets you set for your organization and your employee targets, that really promote the outcome. Here the outcome is the performance. And you give more time to spend on the monitoring and evaluation. You don't do it in a 1 day or 2 days. You have to give such a period of time to analyze and evaluate your employees. How can you monitor, and then what are the results of the monitoring your employees? With monitoring or without monitoring, what is the results or what are the outcomes? And avoid duplication of information. You don't give the redundant data to your information. You don't give a duplication of your information. You just avoid it. Because if you give the duplication, for example, Ramesh has done 10 units of products. And Suresh has given only 6 units of production. So 10 and 6 is different. But if you give a duplicate of information and you enter twice, the Ramesh has given 6 and Ramesh has given 6. So at the employee code, it is treated as the 6 plus 6, it is 12. So Suresh has benefited with the duplication of that. That's the reason you don't give it. But due to the technology and the software support today, we don't have the duplication of it. So it is only possible with the manual entries. Next, the management and evaluation system should take account of the diversity of government. So how can we diversify? What are the regulations of the government? And then what is the maximum target you have to give to your employees by the order of the government? Or a legal structure, or else the unions, and they are given some particular targets which are only up to these targets only they can achieve. So you have to consider all the things, and maybe you may diversify your targets and other things. You should only with the help of the government and its decisions. You promote the demand for M&E evidence so as to strengthen your supply. So how can we promote the demand for monitoring evaluation? So it is for example, some of the companies they use for monitoring as this one, the CC cameras, and they monitor, they use the public mic system and they evaluate, and then if anyone not working, taking rest and wasting the time at a work premises, they announce in public mic system. They record it and then they make it as an evidence. So at the same time, you can observe, is it really the employee's fault or else it is a working fault? Maybe it may be working fault or a managerial decision, which is about if a department requires 12 people, you only recruit only 7 or 8 people to manage. So then it is not a possible thing. It weakens the supply of your organization. You have to strengthen it. It is only possible with the proper management of human resources and manpower planning. So then everybody is working well and everybody is working without stress. These are all very important aspects in the monitoring evaluation. What is the process of monitoring? Simple thing, for monitoring your employees or monitoring a task or execution of a particular work, you simply identify the gaps in performance plan and demonstration. Because the performance plan includes different activities and different executive levels, the execution levels. Whereas the gap between this plan and whatever the demonstrations given by a manager to their employees and those who are involved in that particular task, we should have some gap. So based on that gap, we cannot do well. So in monitoring, we can identify that gap. If you properly monitor and evaluate it, definitely you can identify such kind of the demonstration gaps. Then what will you do? You just simply discuss. So as per the directions given by the top management, and then whatever the feedback provided by you, we develop the improvement plan. This is the plan and these are the changes in monitoring process. So you have to work like this will be advisable. So you have to clearly communicate those improvement plans to your employees. Some organizations, they don't give any information to their employees, but they are monitoring their employees. Then they cannot consider it as their performance. That is the reason you have to discuss. Get the feedback from your employees about difficulties in executing the performance plan. Your expectation is 100, but the actual is only 80. Why? You discuss with them. You identify those gaps. You better to conduct a feedback mechanism and get the feedback. And based on that feedback and with the discussion, you can develop an improvement plan. So everybody has to appreciate it. And then they can learn that yes, we have these opportunities to develop or to provide good performance to the organization. And you seek employee commitment and verify for adherence. So showing commitment of employee leads job satisfaction and more productivity. So it's not a simple task that every employee shows the commitment when they are satisfied with the organizational objectives, targets given, the performance measurement scale, etc. You just verify it, whether they are committed or not. If not, you just ask, you discuss with those people, why? What are your expectations? If those expectations are really good, encourageable, and it really improves the performance of that employee as well as the other employees, then you can consider those and you can intimate to your top management. For every time you have to seek your employee commitment and you verify, and based on that only we can monitor the and we can assess or evaluate their performance. What are the ways of monitoring? So basically we have 4 monitoring ways. The first one is periodic review. Periodic review. A periodic performance review is a self-assessment of standards, all of which are applicable to a healthcare organization. You can take an example of it. The Joint Commission of Healthcare Organization conducts surveys of healthcare organizations. It involves the annual assessment of an organizational performance. So they can take it as an annual basis. So here, it helps to determine organizational readiness for an accreditational audit. So why we take the periodic reviews? So some organizations, they take it in every quadrant. Some organizations, they take it off yearly. Some particular organization, they take it as annually. So here, the periodic reviews really reduces the complexity of auditing your performance. Because for every quadrant, they have to give your performance reports. You know where you are. What is your performance level? How can you work? And then what is the estimation and what is the actual? Everything you and your organization should know, and based on that, you can work. The second way is problem solving. What is problem solving? Problem solving is the act of defining a problem, determining the causes of the problem, identifying, prioritizing, and selecting alternatives for a solution, and implementing a solution. So problem solving is a process of identifying what is the problem, why the problem occurs, what are and whom should take care of these problems, what is the solution you generate, the alternatives or solutions to the problem, and you take one of the best solution for the problem and you can implement it. So in that way you can monitor. For example, if you identify a problem of an employee that he cannot manage his life balance. What is life balance in HR? Work-life balance. If you have a problem in working area, it is a work balance. If you have a problem in your personal life, it's called a life balance. You cannot balance your life. So every human, they have the personal problems, but you don't carry those problems to your organization. It cannot be affect are affected your work progress or the performance. So you identify those problems and you counsel them. And then if it is really a problem your organization may solve, you just solve it. So these are all some examples of problems. For example, if you take an employee and he has a problem of his mother is on bed rest, and he needs to take care of her mother because he is only the single child and he is not married and no father. So only he is only the person take care of her mother. So at that time you have to give some time, or else you can give a flexible working hours to those people, and you can give some relaxation so that they can work well and they can give good outcomes to you in near future. But the traditional organization didn't allow such relaxations, but the modern organizations, they can give such kind of working environment. You can work at home, you can work at your available time or peaceful time, but you need to complete the targets given by organization within a period of time or a fixed time given by your organization. That depends on the nature of the job and the size of your organization. The third one is engendering trust. Engendering trust. Trust is the glue that holds organizations and relationships together. We all know how difficult it is to be in a personal relation with someone we don't trust. And it is just as difficult to work for someone we don't trust. In work relations, leaders have a responsibility to build and maintain trust within their organizations. So the trust is a matter of the leadership. The leader is responsible for creating the trust among the people, because if you don't trust a person, you cannot mingle with him or you cannot work together without the trust. So creating a trust or that kind of environment is the responsibility of a leader. The fourth one is the role efficiency. So what is role efficiency? The top managers play a lead in the entire process. We know every role is very important, and the top management's role is a lead role. By setting trends for the lower ranks, they acting as role models for the employees. The efficiency is equal to the skill. What skill? You have 12 types of skills that we discuss in next slide, right? So development activities, what are the development activities? So how can you develop your employees? So if you want to develop your employee, so you need to coach them. So coaching is one of the key, and it is about your employees for getting the more knowledge and skills at workplace. So for this coaching, we have 6 steps. The first step is show confidence in employees' ability and willingness. So you encourage them and you treat them as they are very effective and they have an ability to work. The step two is describe the performance problem to the employee. So whatever the problems you have, you just describe it, and then based on that they can develop their performance and they can learn. The step three is determining whether the issues exist that limit the employee's ability to perform. So for these things, we commonly have the barriers that of the time, the lack of training, the tools, and temperament. So we have to overcome these problems, and then we can coach them towards the best results. The next one is you just remove all the barriers and determine the needs of the employee. Whatever the needs they have, you simply facilitate it. The step 5 is discuss potential solutions to the problems. You make them to participate in decision making. The last step is agree on a written action plan. So whatever they give the suggestions, you just take it, and then whatever solutions, you simply agree, and you just forward it to your top management, and you can take the decision. So this is a very key important aspects in coaching. And second one is counseling. Counseling is used to improve the performance. When the manager has identified a problem with any employee and their current performance level, so that if they are not satisfied or there is no improvement for employee performance, in such cases, we counsel the employees and make them to work more, and we match their objectives with organizational objectives. So these are all the key areas in counseling. The next one is concept. So we have different types of concept that we develop among the employees, especially the social, physical, emotional, cognitive, and cultural changes. It really takes place throughout the lifespan of an individual in the organization as well as in the society. And the last one is the skills. So basically, we have 12 skills which are required for the HR manager and need to develop their employees. The first one is the communication skill. Second one is administrative skills. Third one is knowledge and expertise. Fourth one is proactive. Fifth one is advising. Sixth one, coaching. Seventh one, recruitment and selection. Eighth one, human resource information system about the knowledge. And the next one is intercultural sensitivity and language skills. 10th one, analytical driven and oriented. And 11th one is HR reporting skills. And final one is the teamwork. So these are all the skills which are required for the development of your employees. So based on these things, we have developed our employee and their performance levels.